Tony Schiavone and Jesse the Body Ventura. And what a wild fight we ended up last week right here on Worldwide between Ravishing Rick Rude and Nikita Koloff. We do understand from Bill Watts there have been fines levied to Rude, Koloff, and to Terrence Taylor.
I'll tell you what, I think Bill Watts is totally out of line on this one. The culprit in this was Nikita Koloff. He was the instigator. If you remember, Schiavone, he's the one that ran into the opposite dressing room. He's the one that caused all the problem. I don't think Rude should have been fined. I don't think the tailor-made man should have been fined. They were simply defending themselves.
$5,000 each for Ravishing Rick Rude and for the Russian Nightmare Nikita Koloff. Now, on the program this week, the world champion Big Van Vader, and I have an in-depth interview with the former champion Sting.
Well, I'm interested to hear what Sting's got to say, because down the line, he's going to face Vader again.
Plus, Nikita Koloff against the tailor-made man. But right now, let's go to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Macon, Georgia, weighing 235 pounds, he says he's the prettiest in World Championship Wrestling, Johnny B. Bag. His opponent from Chicago, Illinois, 275 pounds, Mark Zuckerberg.
I'm so pretty!
Johnny B. Badd begins the hour this week here on Worldwide against Big Mean Mark Canterbury. Very colorful individual, all decked out in red, white, and blue.
Yeah, that's right. But you know what, Schiavone? Let's talk about those fines that were levied. Heavyweight fines here in WCW. Nikita Koloff, who deserved to get fined for his display, ravishing Rick Rude. Fines, 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 Schiavone.
And the tailor-made man as well. Like we said at the top of the program, Johnny B. Badd. Oh, wow. The glitter is everywhere. And behind all that glitz and glitter, there is a tremendous athlete who is a top contender for Brent Armstrong's WCW light heavyweight title. Now, Canterbury is a much bigger guy, but Johnny B. Badd wrestles with an abundance of confidence, and here we go.
He's given up a lot of height and weight here, though. Bad better move, he better be quick, and the referee better not make him use the closed fist or let him buy with that closed fist.
Ducked out of the way. Johnny B. Badd, using the quickness you talked about. Fans, as we said, exclusive interview with Sting still to come that I had. It was a tremendous interview. From behind, Johnny B. Badd with a takedown. Trying to hook an arm to send him over, but no, Canterbury finds the ropes.
Well, Badd's being real smart early. He's hitting and he's moving, he's ducking behind, and he's not trying to match up strength with the bigger man.
Goes in with a tie-up, Fireman's Carry takeover. And Johnny B. Badd showing the world what he's made of, showing a tremendous amount of quickness, and in the same breath, getting Canterbury real frazzled. Canterbury upset. The big guy goes to the forearm dragon twist of his own. Right on to Johnny B. Badd. Badd counters. Once again, a great pickup. And a fireman's carry takeover.
Standing fireman's carry that time. Sometimes a wrestler will go to the knee and do it. That time, Johnny B. Badd did it from the standing position.
And we talked about his quickness, showing a great deal of power that time as well. Canterbury finds the face.
Canterbury caught Badd in the corner right there with a big elbow, and that's what he's got to do. Cut the ring off. Don't let this guy use the speed.
Good takeover. Drop kick executed. Johnny B. covers. One, two, got a two count. Arm drag takeover, and Johnny B. Badd now. Good to see Nick Patrick back with us. As you know, one of our great referees had been injured in an automobile accident. He is back now, looking great shape. Roll up here. One, two. Johnny B. got a two count. Arm drag takeover again.
And you saw Badd cinch get underneath real deep in that arm drag. That's what you need for the leverage to get the bigger man to go over the top if he's got you outweighed.
To the head. Once again, boy, Canterbury. You were right, Jesse. When he cuts Johnny B. Badd off in the ring, he really can work over it.
Absolutely.
Left hand.
Ref should not count this.
One, two, three, it's over.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Johnny B. Badd.
When we come back, we'll relive what happened in the dressing room last week between Rick Rude and Nikita Koloff, and then Nikita Koloff against the TaylorMade Man.
Welcome to this edition of this week's WCW Magazine. Last week here in the magazine, we showed you what happened during a recent altercation at the Great American Bash on tour between the Junkyard Dog and Mr. Hughes, also known as the Big Cat. It was interesting indeed because it was the Junkyard Dog who was the first person to call medical attention to the Big Cat after the Big Cat was on the receiving end of a Junkyard Dog headbutt. Well, the Big Cat is standing by right now, and he has these comments for the Junkyard Dog.
I know you people have seen the footage of my injury and had a lot of time to think about my career and where I'm going in this business. But during that time when I was out in that ring and I felt the presence of JYD, I felt him and I heard him call for help, which made me feel so good about him and myself. So JYD, let me tell you, anything in this world that the Big Cat can do for you, you call on me, brother.
Well, it's going to be very interesting to hear from the Junkyard Dog and get his response to those comments from the Big Cat. And we'll try to have that for you right here on the WCW Magazine. And later on in the hour, we'll be back and take a close-up look at a very interesting situation that's developing between Dirty Dick Slater, Greg Valentine, and the Natural Dustin Rhodes and Barry Windham. And we're going to hear from the WCW World Tag Team Champions, Dr. Death Steve Williams and Terry Bam Bam Gordy.
Last week on Worldwide, we were all treated to ravishing Rick Rude and Nikita Koloff for the U.S. title. We expected a great match. We got one. What we didn't expect is what would happen afterwards in the dressing room. And here's exactly what happened. And there's Nikita Koloff at Rude's dressing room door. He's going in the dressing room.
Look at this. They're going at it inside the dressing room. Nikita Koloff. But Koloff is in the wrong dressing room. Look at Terry Taylor.
In the dressing room fighting. What a wild scene. Many wrestlers in. There's Wyndham, Fatler, and Van Hammer. Ron Simmons.
This is an out-of-control brawl, Tony Schiavone.
Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Vero Beach, Florida, weighing 236 pounds, the TaylorMade Man.
What a brawl it was just last week, as we said at the top of the program. Not only Koloff and Rude fined each $5,000, Taylor fined what we understand is an undisclosed amount of cash for taking part in that brawl and stomping on Koloff when he came to the dressing room.
And I think that was totally unfair. It was Koloff that instigated the whole thing.
Let's go back to Gary Capetta.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent at 121 kilos, originally from Lithuania, now residing in the United States of America, Nikita Koloff.
Koloff after Taylor. He's after everybody. You know, I have never seen a more focused athlete than Nikita Koloff. And you can better believe he has one thing on his mind, ravishing Rick Rude.
Well, he better have a second thing on his mind right now, and that's the TaylorMade Man.
Sending Taylor in. Well, you're right, Jesse. That is the Russian Hammer that he was so known for. Right in on the TaylorMade Man. Caught the leg. Spins him around. Atomic drop. And the power of Koloff again. Boy, is he ready or what this week?
He's ready. He can beat up men and he can even beat up women.
Well, Medusa has been more than involved in Rick Rude's matches with Koloff as Koloff lays in a shoulder. Well, he is just beating up the TaylorMade Man, and not many people can say that early in the match they can get this much of an advantage against Terrence Taylor. Moved out of the way. Good counter move.
Absolutely. It was a desperation move, I think, on the part of the TaylorMade Man. Whoa, and he dropped him right on his head, the chin to the head.
The jawbreaker maneuver, as Taylor calls it, and drives in a knee using the ropes. And a warning from Randy Anderson asserting himself here, one of our great WCW referees.
Yeah, but the TaylorMade man's a veteran. He knows he's got till the count of five to break, and he's going to hold it till the very possible instant, the count of four, because he can get away with that. You can't disqualify him on four. You can only disqualify him on five.
And he's working on a throw to Koloff here, trying to cut the wind off. Keep the big man maybe weary and therefore can neutralize it. And he's being very effective with it. He's had a chokehold. He tried to go to the throat there. Koloff blocked it. In the corner, Taylor goes to the head again, this time to the eyes, and breaks the eyes. Boy, Taylor taking every shortcut he can, isn't he?
Hey, when you're in there against a guy, you know Koloff's going to take every shortcut there is. You got to fight fire with fire.
Foot to the face. Head first. Pounding the head of Taylor. Terrence Taylor's weary, and there you see the man who wants to be the U.S. champ, who says it stands for freedom. Freedom that he wants, Big Shoulder.
Hey, I'll tell you what stands for freedom is the money you get with the U.S. title. That's what gets you freedom.
Russian Sicko covers and wins.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Nikita.
Go back to replay right here. There you see the Russian Sickle. Wham! Koloff catching the TaylorMade man right in the throat and chin area. Hooks the leg. Referee in position. 1-2-3. Big win for Nikita from Lithuania.
The awesome barbarian in action when Worldwide comes back after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, parts unknown, weighing 296 pounds, the Barbarian! And his opponent from Honolulu, Hawaii, 211 pounds, Chris Sullivan.
The Barbarian and Chris Sullivan in this matchup. Fans, don't forget an exclusive in-depth interview with Sting, still to come. Plus, Stunning Steve Austin, the Z-Man, and yes, the world champion, Big Van Vader, is here. Still a coming the hour, but right now, Sullivan and the Barbarian is not feeling this at all.
Wow, did you see that? Sullivan trying to lay in some forearms. The Barbarian just looked at him and smashed him.
Looked at him and smashed him into the corner to the other side. Wow, took his head right off literally that time. Fans standing, awing this mammoth man. Gary Capetta said parts unknown. Actually, he's probably from wherever he wants to be. Sending Sullivan in.
Wait a minute, isn't parts unknown in Idaho?
No.
No?
Maybe in Utah.
Oh, all right. Parts unknown, Utah. Okay.
Look at that. Using his chest now.
I'll tell you one thing, though, Shivani. They must have some unique barbers in parts unknown.
Chokehold is applied, and Mike Atkins is quick to make a count.
He better make a counter. The Barbarian's going to murder this guy.
A pickup. Back break. Wow, right on the lower back that time. And I mean with force.
Wow. You could see his back snapping like a rubber band right there.
The Barbarian is awesome. There's some awesome man who certainly would sign the contract to face him, such as a guy like Ron Simmons.
Sullivan with nothing left. Look at this power move.
With ease, he just drops him down, and that time he landed on the knee. I could have blown out a knee right there. All right, the Irish whip to the right side. Big, oh, wow!
Hello!
He's out! 1, 2, 3, he is awesome!
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the Barbarian!
There's just too much man there. The awesome Barbarian back at WCW with a vengeance. With the big foot sending out Chris Sullivan.
Here you see the Barbarian. Here's the backbreaker we talked about. Look at this. Wow, Sullivan's back snapping like a rubber band right there, the pain. And look at this, what a wake-up call this is. Wham, the boot to the chin. Knocks Sullivan silly, knocks him into the next world. Barbarian hooks the leg. Not a pretty face, but an effective wrestler and a big win.
Coming up next, stunning Steve Austin against the Z-Man and an interview Jesse conducted with Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. But right now, WCW Magazine.
Welcome to this edition of WCW Magazine. Last week here in the magazine, I showed you what happened recently while I was trying to conduct an interview with the Natural, Dustin Rhodes. It started out as a war of words between Greg Valentine and Rhodes and quickly escalated into an all-out attack at ringside. Rhodes was scheduled to compete in six-man tag team action with his partners Nikita Koloff and Barry Windham. They were to face Dirty Dick Slater, Greg Valentine, and the Barbarian. But because of the injuries that Rhodes sustained at ringside, he was prevented from participating. We'll take a look and see what happened later on in the evening when Dustin Rhodes couldn't stand by any longer.
Because we've been told that Dustin Rhodes will be unable to compete in the six-man tag team event. It looks as if the Barbarian will be sent back to the locker room. Wait a minute, there's the Barbarian. The Barbarian's out here. Oh, my gosh. He slams Steamboat right on the floor. And there's Dustin Rhodes up on the apron. He's got his leg heavily bandaged. And the referee's going to allow the tag. So I guess we've got a six-man tag after all. Now, wait a minute. Slater off the top. Slater off the top. The ref was putting Steamboat out. Slater came off the top. And they're going to win it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the team of Dirty Dick Slater, Greg the Hammer Valentine, and the Barbarian.
Barry Windham and Dustin Rhodes, two tall Texans that have stood side by side to face so many battles, and nothing's changed now. Barry Windham and Dustin Rhodes are standing by and looking forward to an opportunity to get into the ring with Dirty Dick Slater and Greg the Hammer Valentine. Let's go to the Natural and Barry Windham, see what's on their mind.
Dirty Dick Slater and Greg the Hammer Valentine. Greg, you tried to injure my leg on national television. You tried to hurt me and put me out of professional wrestling, but it didn't happen and you did not get the job done. Now, sooner or later, down the road, in the ring, out of the ring, wherever it may be, you're gonna have to face the Natural Dustin Rhodes and you're gonna have to face Big Barry Windham from Texas. And when that day comes, all the fans around this world are gonna be watching and I'm gonna go out there and I'm gonna kick your tail, pal.
Slater and Valentine, Dustin and I have spent a lot of time together, and we've had a lot of time to talk about pain. I can tell you what pain is about, and Dustin narrowly escaped. This time, you're going to feel the pain.
Barry Windham and Dustin Rhodes, two athletes that have never backed down from a challenge, and they're not going to start now. They want a shot at Greg the Hammer Valentine and Dirty Dick Slater. I'm Eric Bischoff. This has been the WCW Magazine, and later on in the hour, we'll be back, and we'll be hearing from the WCW World Tag Team Champions, Dr. Death Steve Williams, and Terry Bam Bam Gordy. More action coming at you right here on Worldwide.
Okay, a couple of weeks ago, Jesse the Body Ventura, my colleague, had a chance to talk to an injured Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Here's how that conversation went and what happened during the interview.
I'm here with one of the great stars in World Championship Wrestling, the one, the only, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Mr. Steamboat, I gotta give you credit because you were involved a little while ago in what I consider, in all my years of wrestling, the toughest tag team tournament that I have ever witnessed, and you accounted for yourself extremely well in that tournament.
Well, Jesse, you're totally right. I would have to call it the Tag Team Tournament from Hell. Teams from all around the world participated for the NWA World Tag Team Championships. And as Nikita Koloff and myself advanced to the semifinal round against Doc and Bam Bam Gordy, in the course of that match, I suffered a rib injury.
That's right, I'm aware of it. I saw the move. Dr. Death caught you in a backbreaker, drove the knee into your ribs, and I knew it right away. The ribs were injured. How are the ribs right now?
Well, as it shows in the x-rays, that I will be out of wrestling for an undetermined length of time. But in the course of that injury, it also cost me a very, very dear opportunity
as Steve Austin for the World TV title. In that, Steve Austin, I'm not crying over spilt milk, but the fact remains that the opportunity will come my way again. What is going on here? What?
I gave you a title shot, Steamboat, and you blew it. You will get no more shots at the World Television title. You were laying at home and you say you were nursing some bruised ribs. Maybe you were, maybe you weren't. I guess you need something to hide behind. Now, I'm not calling you a chicken, Steamboat, but a real athlete would not have missed this opportunity.
Come on, you want to get
Hey, hold it. Hey, this is an interview now.
You want to bring yourself over here right now and get it on? I am a true athlete, Austin. Hurt ribs or no hurt ribs, I'll take you on right now. Bring it over here.
Well, Ricky the Dragon, wait now. He does make a point. He is the television champion. He can defend it against anybody he wants to. And if it so chooses, it won't be you.
You know, Jesse, you're right. He is the TV champion. And he has that right to decide whether to defend it who against. But let me tell you something, Jesse. These bruised ribs put me down for a while. But patience is a virtue. And this man has a lot of patience. And Steve Austin, I will get my opportunity with you. Somewhere down the line, you will have an adversary that has an injury. And that's when this man will step out of the crowd.
The Z-Man held the World Television title at one time and was a great World TV champ. Gets another title shot right now as we go back to Gary Capetta.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent. He will be accompanied by the Chief Executive Officer of the Dangerous Alliance, Paul E. Dangerously. He's from Hollywood, California. He weighs 253 pounds, and he is the WCW World Television Champion, Stunning Steve
Well, Jess, you had that interview 2 weeks ago with Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Austin was rather belligerent towards Steamboat, but Steamboat, I know, once he gets healthy, will be back after Austin.
Well, the question is, as I pointed out, though, Shivani, it's whether Austin and Dangerously want to give Steamboat a shot. But right now, Austin's got to worry about the Z-Man. He can't be worrying about Ricky the Dragon because he's got an opponent in there, as you said, that is a former TV champ himself.
It is for the World TV title. Nick Patrick is the referee, and the Z-Man looked towards Paulie. He needs to stay focused on his opponent here, Stunning Steve Austin, the most dominant World TV champ the sport has ever known. And the Z-Man, trying to start out quickly now, goes right to the side headlock, trying to get the first initiative here. Whoa, press. One! Only a one. Right back up with the head again. Slips from behind. Drop kick.
He didn't quite catch him with all of that drop kick, but he sunk the arm drag in into the arm bar, and the Z-Man looking very, very good here in the early going.
They exchange full arm drag and twist now. Walks up the turnbuckle and holds on nicely to take him over. One. And a one count there.
You know, Shivani, that's the tough thing about being a champion. No matter what championship you hold, everyone is gunning for you. You don't get a night off when you hold the belt here in WCW.
Well, I would agree, but also, as you know, the rules in WCW, you've got to beat the champion. He doesn't have to beat you. That's very simple.
And that's the way it should be.
Well, I didn't say it. That's not the way it should be. Into the ropes now.
Don't get belligerent with me.
Moving out of the way, Z-Man, tremendous quickness. Austin, right in the face, he covers it, one, two. It was that type of move that he won the World TV title with. Austin caught him that time, though. He's got him up, backbreaker.
Well, you can see when Z-Man went to go up the ropes, his foot slipped on the turnbuckle. He didn't get the leverage he needed to take Stunning Steve over. Steve held him up there and dropped him down, and Austin has changed this match dramatically with that one little mistake by the Z-Man, the foot slipping.
Head first to a neutral corner. pick up Austin, trying and getting the belly to back suplex. Cover. One. Got a one count. Takes him down again with a drop toe hold and also using the head. Now driving into the back. Since the backbreaker, he has worked on the back of the Z-Man very effectively now. And you can better believe when Steamboat gets better, and if he gets the title shot, and I'm sure he will, he'll work on the ribs as well.
Here's a wear down move right here. You can see the knee into the spine, the reverse chin lock, and he's pulling back on the Z-Man. Z-Man gonna have to try to bridge his way to take some of the pressure off.
Z-Man is in trouble, there's no doubt about it. Foley continues to berate him from the corner there. Fans, we want to remind you, coming up next, the exclusive interview with the world champion, former world champion Sting, I should say, and then the world champion, Big Van Vader, will be here. Now the fans. Z-Man back up to a vertical base. Drives the elbows in, but Austin with a head of hair. Z-Man sending Austin in.
Great move by the Z-Man. He blocks stunning Steve. He's going for a suplex.
Can he hook him?
No.
Austin on him. One, two, and oh, two count.
Austin has hurt his back. You can tell that. He's hurt the Z-Man's back. Z-Man going for that suplex. Didn't have the strength to get him up there. Almost cost him the bout as Stunning Steve came down on him for a two count.
He has taken, there's the reverse chin lock again. A tremendous amount of punishment from the World TV champ, but still the Z-Man continues to try to get up and execute a move.
You know, Shivani, one of these days, I'll grab you in one of them, and then you'll have the experience to talk about what Z-Man's feeling right there. How would you like that?
Well, it's probably been a long time since you put one on somebody. Can you do it like you used to?
Oh, yeah, especially to you.
Paulie having a good time at the expense of the Z-Man now, the World Television Champion.
I think that's a good idea, Shivani. From now on, every week before we come on, I'll put you in some type of hold.
Okay, I'll think about that as we take a look. Boy, I mean, he is really hooking the neck. He has worked on the back and the neck of the Z-Man.
5 minutes gone in the match, 5 minutes remaining in time limits.
Well, we're halfway through the television time limit here. That's another advantage the TV champion's got.
That's exactly right. That's what I talked about. You have to beat the World TV champ. You know, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat has held just about every major title in the world, including the World Heavyweight title. He is focused now on the World TV title. And he is focused on stunning Steve Austin. What a great match it would be between two great athletes. Z-Man, you got to give the Z-Man a lot of credit here, Jess. He's taking a lot of punishment, but look, he's up to a vertical base again.
Absolutely, he's powering his way, drives the elbow in.
To the midsection. Z-Man snatches a headlock here. Austin threw him off. Good move by Austin to drop down. Oh, he got him in the midsection. Sending Z-Man out. Boy, Austin is quick as a cat.
Well, you know, the Z-Man tried that stall delay move earlier. He caught Stunning Steve. Whoa! Z-Man got out too far. Stunning Steve couldn't reach him with that elbow.
And Z-Man moved out of the way. In the corner. Missed an elbow. Drop kick. Drop kick, Z-Man.
He missed an elbow and caught a drop kick.
And now Z-Man hurt back at all. Sending Austin in. He got the drop kick again.
And look at Paul Lee outside the ring. He's irate. He can see the title slipping away.
And he got him up. He got him up. Trying to make a cover. Super kick. Z-Man covers. Here it is. One, two. And Austin's out of it. Barely.
Well, he missed that super kick. He got him only partially with it, not full effect.
Sending Z-Man in. Sleeper hold. Oh, head first to the turnbuckle. What a smart wrestler Austin is. Picks up Z-Man, stun gun. Got the stun gun, got the one, the two, and got the win.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner and still WCW World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin.
All right, fans, when we come back, my interview with former champion Sting. Don't you dare go away.
Friendly colleague Tony Schiavone, who is standing by with the long-awaited in-depth interview with the former WCW heavyweight champion Sting.
There's no question the most dramatic moment in all of professional sports is when the world's heavyweight championship changes from one athlete to the other. It happened back on July 12th, the Great American Bash, when Big Van Vader became world heavyweight champion. I want to thank the former champion Sting for spending some time with me. A lot of fans have asked me this question. I want to ask you. Certainly, we all feel that you have to be down right now. Are you down?
Absolutely not, Tony. As a matter of fact, right now I probably feel more determined than I ever have.
Okay, let's take a look at the match. You're going up against a man 450 pounds. You know it's going to be a fight for the world heavyweight title. What was your game plan going in?
Well, I knew it had to be completely different against a guy like this, 200-pound difference like you were talking about, than anybody else that I'd ever faced before. And I knew that the first 10 minutes of that match were more crucial minutes than I'd ever had in any match that I've ever had in my whole wrestling career. And I knew if I could just outlast him that first 10 minutes that I'd probably survive it and come out ahead.
You know, I was sitting with Ron Simmons during the match, and we talked about the first part of the match, how you continued to go right after Big Van Vader, straight after him. You know, we talk so much about the power of the big guy. But during the match itself, you showed a lot of power of your own. I mean, a lot of power.
You're probably talking about when somehow or another, I hoisted him up onto my back. I don't know how I did that either, but when the adrenaline is flowing in a match like that, I guess you can do more than you might believe. But yeah, I picked him up, got him up on my back, and finally got straight up in the prone position and went back and tried to get the wind knocked out of him. And I thought maybe that would be a turning point right there.
I want to bring up something everyone has asked. As a matter of fact, we got a call this morning from a newspaper in London, and they want to go back to Beach Blast when you signed to face Cactus Jack. Pinfalls count anywhere on the Gulf Coast. Many people feel that maybe that was a mistake. What do you think about signing that match? Did you think it was a mistake coming in?
Tony, I'm a professional, and I'm a professional for World Championship Wrestling. And that match against Cactus Jack, I was geared for. I was geared and ready for that match. And I was geared and ready for a world title match against Big Van Vader, so I'm not making any excuses at all.
Well, I know you're never the one to make excuses, but now as we go back to the world title match against Big Van Vader, can you single out one point that you thought was maybe the turning point of the match?
Yeah, I would have to say when I went for a belly-to-back suplex or a German suplex, and he caught me with a big elbow and knocked me sort of silly for a minute, and so I grabbed the first thing that came, body part that came into my way, and it happened to be his head in a headlock. Instantly, he picked me up and was going to drop me backwards, and I knew if I didn't get out of that, that one could be it. So I had to cut the flip over the back of him. Lucky for me, ended up in the same position. I got that belly-to-back suplex, and I thought right there that was a turning point.
I think many people did. I saw the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. He was on the edge of his seat. I even looked at Harley Race at ringside. As a matter of fact, I thought it was about a 6 or 7 or even an 8 count at that time.
No, 6 or 7 or 8 count. Tony, it seemed like an eternity to me. Unbelievable.
Okay, let's talk about the man in the corner and the big stinger splash that time. What was going through your mind, actually, at that time?
Well, big guy like that, I mean, I'd been lugging around, think about it, lugging around 450 pounds right, for 20 minutes or whatever it was. I was worn out.
Yeah.
And I just misjudged it, just simply misjudged it, not to mention the size of his back is almost like a wall, and we were both so sweaty from the battle and the hot lights and everything else, I think maybe I slid off him a little bit as well as misjudging it, and I caught my head on the part of the metal turnbuckle there.
Right. But you still gave it one last desperation shot.
Yeah, I did. After I hit, I remember, I think, being all the way out because I didn't hear anything, and then all of a sudden hearing Sting, Sting. You can hear the crowd, you know, in the roar.
Right.
And I finally shook a little bit off there and just sort of fell down. And I remember Vader finally covering me right there, and I knew, yeah, this is it. All of a sudden, things just start to snap for you, and I just barely got an arm up. And then, Tony, I remember a couple of wild swings there. I was going for the home run hit right there. I knew if I didn't connect on one of them that that probably would be it. And that big last right that I took, the big home run, didn't connect. And really, I don't remember what happened after that.
But still, the entire end of the match has to be painful for you to think about that.
Tony, it's not painful. Believe me, it is not painful at all. As a matter of fact, painful is being put into a corner. Painful is not knowing what to do the next time you're against Big Van Vader. But I'm not. There's no pain involved because I know what I have to do. And I have one last thing to say. And I want to say this to my fans, and I want to say this to all the little stingers, is I have turned it up not one notch, but I've turned it up two notches, and I'm going to be ready for you, Vader.
Our thanks to Sting.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, a special handicap match, 2-1. Introducing first, he is accompanied by 7-time former World Heavyweight Champion, Harley Race, from the Rocky Mountains. Weighing 448 pounds, he is the WCW World Heavyweight Champion, Big Van Vader. His opponent's total combined weight, 444 pounds. First from Baltimore, Maryland, Jumpin' Joey Maggs. And from Clearwater, Florida, Ian Weston.
All right, the world champion, Big Van Vader, quickly gets into it. Quickly, fans, next week I'll be talking to the Junkyard Dog and Dustin Rhodes against Dick Slater, plus beatable Bobby and Arn Anderson. Next week on Worldwide. And right now, the world champion, Big Van Vader. The awesome world champion after Joey Maggs. Oh, my goodness, all that weight in the corner.
I'll tell you what, Big Van Vader, he don't waste no time and he don't waste no opponents. He takes them two at one. Kind of like going in and ordering a double cheeseburger instead of a single one, Shivani.
Sting, the former World Heavyweight Champion. What a great interview we had. And I know he said, I've not turned it up a notch. I've turned it up two notches. And he knows now what it takes to defeat Big Van Vader, he says.
Well, knowing what it takes and accomplishing what it takes can sometimes be two different things. Look at Vader. Stepping back there allows the man to tag. This guy is just brimming with confidence since he became the heavyweight champion.
Whoa. Oh, my goodness.
Whoa. You know what?
What?
I'll tell you what, Williams and Gordy better watch out for this guy by himself. He may want all the gold and hold the tag team titles by himself.
Sending Ian Weston down. Look at Joey Maggs in the corner. He's history. He's not getting back up.
I love it. He's even posing. Not a lot of definition, but definitely mass up there.
I've said it before. Certainly, more than likely, will become the most dominant world heavyweight champion the sport has ever seen. Big Van Vader. The power bomb covers Weston. One, two, it is over.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, the WCW World Heavyweight Champion, Big Van Vader.
Okay, when we come back, Jesse the Body Ventura will talk to Big Van Vader.
Welcome to this final edition of this week's WCW Magazine. Dr. Death Steve Williams and Terry Bam Bam Gordy made their way to World Championship Wrestling from Japan. And when they got here, they said that they were going to become the new WCW World Tag Team Champions. Well, Dr. Death Steve Williams and Terry Bam Bam Gordy achieved that feat, and they became the NWA World Tag Team Champions in 1 week's time. A tremendous feat by two tremendous athletes. Like them or not, here's Dr. Death Steve Williams and Terry Bam Bam Gordy.
You're asking me if we'll give the Steiner brothers another shot at these titles right here. Well, let me tell you something. We'll give anybody a shot at these titles. It don't matter if they're named Steiners or what their names are, right, Doc? We told you people exactly what we were going to do. We took the WCW tag team titles first, then we took the NWA tag team. I'm telling you, people, we're the champions, and all you boys want to put your name on the dotted line, go right ahead.
As competitive as Rick and Scott Steiner have been all of their lives, you can bet that they're looking forward to an opportunity, a rematch with the new WCW World Tag Team Champions, Dr. Death Steve Williams and Terry Bam Bam Gordy. That'd be a match that'll blow the roof off any building in the country. I'm Eric Bischoff. This has been the final edition of the WCW Magazine. We've got more great action coming to you right here on Worldwide, right after this very brief timeout.
Harley Race, 7 times you held that championship, but I know nothing's more gratifying than to be the manager of the current
World Heavyweight Champion Big Van Vader. But I gotta ask you the hard questions, Harley Race. Not only is the former champ waiting for you, Sting, but other people are lining up. People like the All-American Ron Simmons. People like Terry Bam Bam Gordy, Dr. Death Steve Williams, the current tag team champions. Everybody looks for the gold that Big Van Vader now holds.
Jesse, you know as well as I do that every man that you mentioned, all the way from Dustin Rhodes right on through Doc Gordy to Bam Bam to Rick Rude to any of them, take a look at this human being right here, and you tell me that you ever saw an athlete like this anywhere on earth, and you did nothing to compare with this man.
I'll tell you what, you know, Big Van Vader, you're beating him two at a time. Have you ever thought about you alone going after the tag team title?
Brother, let me tell you this. Vader will take on all challengers. Ron Simmons, Barry Windham, Dustin Rhodes. Anybody, Vader is not very hard to find. I'm standing right here. You want a piece of Vader? You sign on the dotted line and come get some, brother.
There you got it. The WCW World Heavyweight Champion for Tony Schiavone. This is Jesse the Body Ventura. We'll see you all.